Remember, I have all these faces selected here on the outside of this bowl. And let me just click Q to, or click on this to get out of that tool. I'm going to apply the first fong that we manipulated, holding down the middle mouse button and just dragging to it. And now it's applied to that outer part. Okay, so I'm going to hit F8 to get back into object mode. And now, we don't need to manipulate the second fong, but now we need to get back into the original that we created. So I'm going to go under Common Material Attributes and go into the color and go all the way to this box here that looks like a checker. Just click on that, and under 2D Textures, make sure you have As Projection selected, and then go to File. Okay, and you should get under Projection Attributes, Projector Type. I'm going to change it to Cylindrical, and go to Image, go to this box here at the far right, click on that. Should take you to File Attributes, go to Image Name, go over here to this box that looks like a folder, click on that, and just look for your file. So I have this file that I found online, kind of a blue frosted glass. And one drawback that sometimes you find about it is that, you know, in order for a glass, outside glass texture to show up, it has to have certain highlights to it. Okay, so that contributes to some of the drawbacks that you're going to have to work within by having that texture. Okay, so I'm going to double click on this fong again, go to where it says projection here in this tab. And again, I've been working on this for a while, so now it says projection 3 for me. If you're just starting within your scene, it should say projection 2 for you. I mean, sorry, projection 1 for you. But either way, you'll have your material and then you'll have projection over here. Under projection attributes, make sure you click fit to B-box. And let me move the hypershade down. You should see a projector going around, a cylindrical projector going around your object right here. Okay, so now once that's set, let me do a quick render. Remember, we already have ray tracing set for both the materials and the renderer. So now, just rendering it out, you see this texture is now showing up on here, and you can still see through it, which is a good thing. You can see through it, you can see the reflections on the outside, and you can still see a little bit through it and see the checkerboard on the back. So I'm going to continue to work on this a little bit. Let me click on the fong again, or click on this tab here. I want to add a bump map. So I'm going to go down to bump mapping. Click on this box at the far right, looks like a checkerboard. Make sure you have As Projection still selected. Go to File, and we're going to go through that same process. Under Projection Attributes, make sure you select the projector type as cylindrical. Under Image, go to this box at the far right, then you go to File Attributes, and then go to Image Name, go to this box here, this button that looks like a folder, and I'm going to look for the glass, my glass 4 here, and it brings it in. So I'm going to double click on the fong, and you can either click on bump map here to get to the depth. I'm going to bring the depth down to maybe 0.7, and let me go back here, go to projection, hit fit to B box, and if I don't get it that way, go to the original tab, go into bump mapping, go to this box here, then it should take you to the projection. It's projection 4 for me, should be projection 2 for you. Make sure cylindrical is selected and click fit to B box. And let's do a quick render. Again, you'll see the projector right here. And I'm hoping that this will render before this video is up. So it's taking a little while because we have ray tracing on it and you have a lot of aspects going along with this. And here we go. Yeah, so the render's almost done. And here we go. You have your frosty colored glass applied here to a fong shader for the inside and out. And there you go. I hope you enjoy. I hope this helps you out.